we're going to do a post survey, and then when you turn that survey over, when I start, it will be some note agenda items to follow. We're doing this. This is on living the blessed life, identifying wellness tools and tips that God has equipped us with naturally in the Word of God and in the Kingdom of God. Okay, I'm going to start with some prayer.
Too loud? Yes, thank you very much.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, I ask that the Holy Spirit would lead us and guide us, bring us truth and liberty and wellness in the Word and in the Kingdom. Identify that for us, Father God, that we may implement it in our individual lives, bring it to our families, to our friends, share it with the world to bring you glory in Jesus' name. I thank you for the opportunity to facilitate what is already you have given us before the foundation of the world. And I pray that within my sisters here, that you would release your spiritual communion, that they too would bring forth what they have that you have given them. So as we share the windows of heaven together, we can see a bigger image of who God is and how loving he is and how he's equipped us here to represent him in the earth in richness and in his glory. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Amen. Okay, so I know it's a little bit confusing, but if everybody comes a little closer, but if you're comfortable where you are, so it's cool. I just want you to know there are not a lot of handouts, but if you can at least do the pre-assessment, can somebody, if you need some paper to write your pre-assessment, I got some paper here. Can somebody pass this for me? Okay, just write your pre-assessment, okay? And then we're gonna do, then you turn that paper back over, and that'll be the agenda we'll follow, that you can do note-taking. So they're going to need two pieces of paper. They're going to need one to do some note-taking on, okay? Sorry, I don't have enough. Okay, as we start off, wasn't it a wonderful presentation Evangelist Versi gave us? Excellent. It was so meaty. It was so great. Okay. Okay.
So it was so great because she talked about words, right? And she says, if we could just get a command over our words, we could get a command over health and wellness and all that. But what is this issue and what's this problem we have with words? What is so unique about women? How many cry at movies? How many of you guys have cried at movies? Okay, scream at movies? How many just watched a commercial and I thought, oh, that was so sweet, like one of those warming commercials. Like, oh, that was so sweet. How many you sit at the table and somebody brought something and you go, ooh, oh, right. Do we just naturally emotional beings? Do you know that Adam, the snake, would not have tried to talk to Adam? Because Adam was more rational. Eve was emotional. He wanted to plant into Eve. So she talked about words. We're going to talk about emotions. And we're going to talk about how the enemy wants to get in you to your emotions, get grounded in your emotions, so you can release your word to give him the yes and amen to bring into your life less than what God intended. And it's easy thing to do because of the fall of man, because of man fell in the garden. Okay, so let's start with emotions. Accepting heavy emotions. Can you name an emotion for me? I was wanting a whiteboard, but you don't have it. Can you name an emotion over here? Happy. Is that a positive or negative emotion?
Positive.
Can everybody show me some happy? Ooh, y'all so pretty. Okay, can you name an emotion over here?
An emotion.
Sad. Can everybody show me sad? Yeah, we all know that look. You know, you can be Chinese, Asian, you know, Russian. We all know that look. Okay, because it's inherent. Emotions are real things. Okay, give me another emotion here. Fear. Can you show me fear? Can I tell you a story about fear? Can I tell you a story about fear? Real story. I'm from Chicago. I don't know how to swim. I can do some backstroke. I can float. No, I can float. That's it. On my back. Can I swim? I grew up in the city. We You know, by the time I went to a school, they finally built the pool. I had no perm, so I snuck out of the gym. Snuck out of the gym while everybody else was swimming. I was hiding in the bathroom, all right? I married this man. I won't tell you everything about him, but he was a southerner. And he lived in Florida, so you know Florida is near water. So he can swim. We would take our kids there, and I would be so fearful. He's a light, like, I don't know why he did. He's in the pan. Why is this brother Channing and my kids up there in the ocean? So I would stay in the ocean. I'm scared. I don't know what to do. But then the kids got bigger, and they got comfortable. They had all these boogie boards and everything. And one day, he said, why don't you just relax? Just sit down. Get a book. And I get a book. I'm so nervous. He gets in there. He comes out and leaves my kids back there. I just get up. I can't find Austin. I have three sons. Eight, 14 months apart, then 18 months apart, right? I can't find Austin. So I start looking. And in the ocean, all of a sudden, looks humongous. And I'm looking. I see the other two boys. Austin! Mike and Danny, where's Austin? Austin! And so I start screaming, I can't find my son! Everybody hears me. The lifeguard hears me. They get up. The people start walking. They start walking slow motion. To me, it's slow motion. And all I'm thinking, my son is in an ocean. I'm not the freaking home. I can't get to him, and I'm so afraid. I can't find my son, Austin! I'm screaming to the top of my lungs. I'm walking through the water like this. People are coming near me. They're coming forward. It's not even their children, but they're coming forward because they got that look in their eyes, and I got this terrible heart is racing, and my mind is about to crazy. And then all of a sudden, what does he have on? I can't even think because, emotions are neurological impulses and my mind is scattered right now. I don't even know what he has on. All I know is I'm tripping and I'm screaming and I'm yelling, Austin! Looking like a crazy one. Austin! And then somebody says, what does he have? And they know there's a few of us black people out there, so they know we just kind of keep look up. We stand up. Is that him over there? Some lady taking a play with her son. And she stops and she turns around and she starts ringing. And right now, I'm still frozen. And all of a sudden, something's coming up in me. And a white woman. It's like she's walking on water. She's walking through that water, pushing her way towards me. And when she gets to me, she gives me a hug. And I start shaking. My body literally starts shaking. And I start crying because I needed to release that emotion. Emotions are real things. There's a Russian study done about 30 years ago. Neurological is the name for it. So emotion is a real thing, and you have to release it. So the knowledge of good and evil had us start calling things bad and giving place to things and taking God out of his sovereignty and allowing us to not hear the signal of the emotion. So it's a complicated thing, but emotions are real things. That's fear. Somebody told me a story one day. I want you to name this, and there may be several emotions. And my sister who shared in Mind in Christ class, I love Mind in Christ class, and she shared her story. I want you to listen, take some notes, see what emotions that you can identify.
Oh, man. No, this did not happen. Yes, it did. I know what I do. I know what I do. I'm a really, really good cook. In fact, all my church members know that I'm a really good cook. So they wouldn't suspect a thing. That's what I'll do. I'll invite her over for dinner. Ring, ring, ring. Hello, Jamie, is this you? Yes, who's speaking? This is Miss Thomas. How are you? I'm fine. Well, honey, I was just thinking about you and, I'm cooking my favorite collard greens and black-eyed peas, sweet potatoes, fried chicken. You know how I do it, girl. I want you to come over today.
Well, girl, I'm not gonna take no for an answer. Come on over.
Okay, you know, you can cook. I'll be right over. Ding dong.
I'm gonna take a little break and let you know there are many emotions in this one, right? As you can see.
So good to see you, girl. Sit down. All right. Oh, girl, this food looks so good. I am so glad you invited me over. And meanwhile, time passes. Sweet potatoes, collard greens, fried chicken, and apple pie a la mode. That was so good. Thank you. You invited me over for dinner. I really appreciate that. I'm glad I invited you too. You know? So you eating? You like that? Yeah. You really like that cookie.
I do.
Well, I'm glad that you feasted and you've eaten my food. And you're full, you look happy. Let me tell you one thing. Don't you ever mess with my husband again. As long as you live, you sitting in my house eating my food, I will poison you. Based on a true story.
She must have been a southerner, you know, kind of oil those grits and everything. Okay, now let's talk about the emotions, okay? What emotions do you think?
Shock.
Mm-hmm. Shock. Okay, maybe shock. Okay, what other emotions do you think?
Surprise.
I put it right there. That's my phone. But I
it's my phone. It's okay. I know it's okay because it's my phone.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to go ahead because I'm sorry, honey, if you can't find your phone. You know, sometimes I didn't steal it. It's not me.
Oh my God.
What is it about emotion sometimes that causes us to lose our focus? Causes us to blame people around us for our issues? You know, it brings frustration in our lives. Brings us stress. And then sometimes it seems that that one little thing adds to all those other little things. All those other little things. And we just start crying. And even though, you ever been in a situation like that? He's like, I guess one more thing. Dang. And you almost want to cry. Say, God, I'm trying. This one little thing, but it's not even the phone. It could be the phone, the job, the husband, and all those things add together. And all of a sudden, you're feeling like this. And she gets weary. She can't feel her joy. She gets lethargic. The joy of the Lord is not sustaining her. She's not feeling the peace. And she starts confessing, I am tired. She's putting negative words on her, I am. I am this, I am this. I am not what God said I am. I am tired. So this is what happens. Thank you very much, Ms. Charlotte Love. Bless you, good. Wasn't all our ladies who came up here to show you. I'm going to say a little bit about the garden. Then we'll get on to exercise. Okay, this is the stuff we already know about the garden. We kind of look at it as an allegory. But God was showing us. He showed us so many principles about the kingdom in the garden. He showed us so many principles about love in the garden. Eve was by herself, emotional. And why don't women talk to change? You can tell your girlfriend. Now, she saw us, and he's going to tell me to come, and he's going to help me buy my $1,000 dress that my mama won't let me buy. So I ain't saying nothing to my mama. I'm going to dishonor my mother, shorten my lifespan. Wellness tip here. Dishonor your parents, shorten your lifespan. Okay, because he signed, said, he's going to take her to prom. Negro. I'm talking to this girl. She's anyway, so why do we talk to snakes? A snake is a snake is a snake.
Uh-huh. Why? May I look like one?
He look like a snake. Well, because he may disguise himself. So we're emotional beings. We talk to snakes, okay? So here she is. She's talking to snakes, and he knew he couldn't talk to Adam, because Adam would say, wait a minute, I ain't had to do nothing. On 7 days, I just showed up. So what if God holding something back for me? I'm in a gravy train right here. But the snake says, Eve, you are. Let me plant this fear in you. God is holding something back. First of all, Adam ain't here. You all by yourself. And God is holding something back. You are missing something. You are without something. So he took the ground because, you know, Eve was made out of what?
Dirt.
She's ground. You can sow it to her. So he sowed deception into her. And Eve was deceived. She didn't disobey. She was deceived. We didn't lose the power to win. To Adam's sin, right? Okay. Let me tell you. This one's point is from the book I wrote called Soul's Work. And right, 48. How did Adam miss what was right in front of him? Because Eve was not the only garden he was to tend. I mean, Eden was not the only garden he was to tend to. So he left Eve alone with nothing to do. And, okay, how could you miss, Adam, what was right in front of you? See, Eden, it was not just Eden, but Eve was the garden you were to tend to. How did you not know what you knew? Eden was not the only ground you were to tend to. So you left Eve alone with nothing to do instead of trusting her to work beside you. This is what's wrong in the black community. To cultivate the garden till it sprang forth truth and unveiled God inside both of you. So unattended Eve was beguiled and she sought the tree of knowledge. What's going to make that selfish tree, that idolatry, self-reliance tree, when there stood the tree of life? And only when Adam failed the chance to cover Eve's sin, the image of God could not be seen in him. Because what Adam said, the woman you gave him. Now, he already been running from God. Now he's in disunity with God. Now God says, will he choose to love? Will he choose to cover? He said, he would. He chose the one to cover. The one that you gave him. Man, they passed the love. They failed the love test. And only when Adam failed the chance to show love and cover Eve's sin, the image of God could not be seen. So God stepped down from his throne into the hearts of men. Thank God. We're going to talk about this. To reclaim and cultivate the garden of the soul where emotions move and redeem man from sin. Okay, so this is in the garden's all perfect, right? Was there wellness in the garden? Yes. Was there ease in the garden?
Yeah.
No disease. No illness. It was wellness. It was great. No bad breath. The sex was good between the two. That's the first time that night that thing went bad. That's when they start spooning each other, turning the opposite way. And Eve, I'm feeling this guilt. I'm feeling this abandonment. I'm feeling shame. Not only am I not for God, I still don't have intimacy with my man. Even when I still long for him, but I'm not getting intimacy because I don't have intimacy with God. And Adam's not getting intimacy with her, so he's busy running something to do. And they're sowing this negative seed down into Cain and Abel. Meaning we're insufficient. We need something for Cain to turn against Abel. Because the mystery of iniquity, we lied about the truth inside us, and then lies brings stealing, and stealing brings murder. So that's the mystery to iniquity. That's why he wanted to clip it at the bud. But the fullness of time had not come. So Jesus had to let us know that we couldn't do without him getting full of ourselves. Anyway, getting back to the garden, getting back to emotions, getting back to what we sown in the very beginning. Shame, pain, guilt, abandonment. And yet still man, because he took the tree of knowledge, thought, I'm self-sufficient. I got this. I'm self-reliant. God said, you know what? They need something, but I'm not going to bring them Jesus yet because they think they got it. You know, sometimes you let your kids run into themselves. They think they got it. What the coolest of time. So, but they need something because this stain, so he gave them this ritual. And he would say later, that the blood of bullocks and all goats is not going to land. That's not going to help. But I'm going to give you this ritual because you got to go through some process of cleansing, of thinking you're removing yourself from it. So they went through this ritual, which they did, of sacrifice. And they would do that for years and years, but it would not clear the conscience. Because the way God created man had gone flip-flop. So his spirit was still not free. That's why Jesus had to come. So we flip-flopped and we did these ritual things to try to keep our emotions in check and give us a law to say what we could not do. But it didn't work. So we still have these emotions. We live on earth. But the tree of knowledge calls us to say, bad, bad, you bad. So when pain would come up and give you a signal, you just stepped on a rock. He stepped on your toe, don't go that way. Now something must be wrong with him. It was just a signal. But now you judge that thing. Now you're pulling that thing to you. Now you're giving that thing your yes and amen. Now you're focusing and giving your power to that thing. So a woman gives her power to my dad, left my mom, she gets a little power to that. She begins to draw that repeating experience, giving deity to that, saying yes amen, giving the freedom, the power that God has given us to liberate and set us free. But God did a good thing because he took us out of Eden and said, you shall not touch the tree of life, because then that thing will be coming forth forever. Because when I bring you the tree of life, then what's going to come out of you is not going to be abandoned in guilt. You're not going to be saying, oh, I'm doing a good thing. God would say, yeah, you're doing a good thing, but you're really doing all this stuff at church because you still have guilt.
Amen.
You're not in grace. I can see it. I still smell it. Mm-hmm. But when I put myself in you, when I love and love constrains you, and you're rooted and grounded in my love and the revelation of my love, and you move out of love because I already forgave you. Mm-hmm. You had a baby out of wedlock. You had an abortion. All look right. At my YouTube. You see me talking about me. Had me in bondage. Mm-hmm. And insecure. And not feeling that I could, you know, how can I be raised in a Baptist church and have an abortion? Kill a baby. I couldn't judge another man who killed somebody. Gave me some compassion, but humbled the hell out of me.
Jesus!
Okay, it's time to dance.
Woo!
Okay, I got my dance partners up with my sisters who have, that I've already talked to you, sunglasses, put your sunglasses on, okay? I need at least eight people. Eight people, I'm gonna show them some dance movements, then we gonna talk, find out who they dancing with, okay? We gonna have somebody who knows
sunglasses. Oh, I don't dance anymore. Dance anymore.
I need two more? Come on, you know. Come on.
Here, Mama got her glasses.
Okay, now while he's getting the music out, again, I'm going to tell you guys to do the cha-cha-cha. Okay, you guys going to do the cha-cha? One, two, cha-cha-cha. One, two, three. Now, you know y'all do hip-hop. Y'all do reggaeton. Y'all do hip-hop. Okay, now, y'all partners. I need a partner over here. Where's my partner? Come on, Pam.
Is released by your the electrical impulses
that your emotions send to your body, they release these things, okay? So adrenaline, if you're always at adrenaline, your heart's racing all the time, because it only should be racing if you're fearful, like you gotta run because the lion's following you, okay? Something like that, you know, you're about to get mugged, you're trying to get to your car. But to live that way, in a relationship that way, it's too much tax on your body. God didn't make you for that anymore. Okay, now let's deal with pent-up anger. Can everybody show the angry face? Now let me show me repressed anger. I'm gonna say that, but you know I can kill you.
Take a poke.
Work in your forehead. I'm angry. No, that's a prayer, let me say that. I'm just saying, these things, people may say these things, okay? What does pent-up anger bring? The big word.
Murder.
Could be, but murdering who? And what's the word here?
Suicide.
Starts with a C.
Cancer.
There's a lot of research talking about how emotions impact you. And it's not always the case, because some things are, we not only have toxic emotions that back up in your body, but we have toxicity, toxic chemicals and stuff in food. And there's some things that are passed down hereditarily. So this is not always the case, but I can tell you when I had backache, God had to heal me on several different levels. I had a backache so bad that I couldn't walk for days, 3 days, 4 days. I was in a store, they had to help me get out. Had to go to, but I had children in succession. My mother said, take time and have your body heal. I didn't listen. Disobedience and honor. And then I felt unsupported. I was down there 30 years without family. A husband who was a basketball player and not attentive, so I felt like no support. Now, I didn't have support. And then I was resentful. I was hurt. I was in unforgiveness. So I had some physical things, and after a while, my hip had come up like this. And I didn't even know it. And if I stayed on my back and I put my legs up, one leg wouldn't hardly come up. God did a number of things to heal me. Had to deal with unforgiveness. I had to walk. He had people pray for me, because we have wellness and people that are gifted to give healings here. And since pastor is saying that this is a vibrant church, healthy, then the healing gifts are about to just come forth. Wow, I'm excited about it. Healing spirit, mind, and body. There'll be people here that will be able to bring forth that deliverance, because he's calling it forth. And we're saying yes and amen every time we speak it. So I had to go through a process. Let me say, some were really interesting. One, when the lady prayed for me at this one church, they told me to come forward. So this gentleman. And when I went forth, I'm going like this. Back and forth. But God was doing something on my spine. I felt like stupid. See, he asked me to come forward, and I looked stupid, going back and forth. But God did something. One time I was bouncing up and down, and then one time in my home, I raised my hands. I worship you, Almighty God. There is none like you. And I start worshiping, and I start turning around, and I'm doing like this, and I'm doing like that. And God is inhabiting my praises. And a man who says, I don't love you, I never loved you, and I won't out. He gave me a crazy praise that I could praise all by myself. I can get out the car and run around the car in my home. Sometimes I cry. Let me tell you this. Emotions are real. So don't say, oh, that didn't happen. But don't put a judgment on it that calls it. God is not who he is. Because this is the scripture I have for you. Say, in him.
I live
and move and have my being. And who is he? The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the El Shaddai, the God who's more than enough. He's the Elohim, the El Elyon, the Jehovah Jireh, the El Shaddai. Who is he? If you in him, you live and have your being. Then does your pain determine who you are and where you are? Because you sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Grab your authority, command your day, and say what God said about you anyway.
Yeah.
I'm going through my sorrow, but weeping may be doing for a night, but joy comes in the morning when I wake up, when I get a clue with the truth of God in me, dunamis, power in my earthen vessel. It's okay, I'm crying. One day I was crying, because really, when you have, when our dog died, we would still throw food on the table, on the floor, because our memory we had coded that memory, and it was in our body, it was in our mind. You can have transplants and still have the memory in that organ.
Right.
So when this man was gone with me, okay, his memory was still there. My brain had to recalibrate
And this is proven, it's research here. So to tell me not to cry ain't got no faith. Oh girl, let me tell you, I cried like a man. And the day I cried like a man, oh God, why me? And I read the notes that he wrote to another man. Don't say nothing else to me about it. Because a God led me to him, but I cried, oh God. I mean, you know when you get based in your cry and your eyes ball up, you know, sometime in the church, when you really get ugly at home. When you really, you know, you've been there, girl, my son heard me. One time he just came and hugged me. I thought you needed that. But when I cried like that, I woke up and I said, came my spirit, I wrote a song. But I can still worship. I can still worship. No matter what I'm going through, I can still worship. I can still worship. No matter what I was going through, my emotions, there was a real place for me. God met me there. And he told me that I was his own. He told me I was beloved of God, and I had to get my natural tools. I started walking that as a wellness thing. Each table, I'm going to be coming to you. When I come to you, I want you to give me a natural wellness thing. And then we're going to go to the scriptures real fast, because the most important thing I have to talk about is Beatitudes and Kingdom of God through the prayer, okay? I need a natural wellness thing. I said walking. Give me one.
Water.
Okay? This table over here, give me a natural wellness thing that God sent us. What?
Love.
Unconditional love. It radiates at 100 megahertz. There are some things that they have tools that they can prove that unconditional love radiates, and that fear radiates at a lower level and causes calamity in the body, messes up your mind. Okay? Sleep. Sleep and rest on this table. God gave us that. God gave us that. He says in Zephaniah 3:17 that I will sing over you with love songs. And he said in your night seasons, ponder. You know, I ain't got that scripture right, but Zephaniah 3:17 says, I will sing love songs over you in the night season.
Okay, what wellness you got?
Just breathing. Remembering to breathe. I was just saying, remembering to breathe, inhale and exhale, because often when we're in stress, we don't.